At one point this weekend, you said that Bitcoin, and this was basically, you were asked, Charlie said Bitcoin's like rat poison. You were asked about that comment, and you said, well, it's probably more like rat poison squared. Charlie went on in the meeting to then basically call Bitcoin turds.
He is an expressive sort, isn't he? Maybe when he gets a little older, he'll mature.
I just want to ask you about that because it sparks so much controversy, and particularly on Twitter and some of the places where you might expect people who are trading in cryptocurrency to be pretty loud about what they heard. What is it about Bitcoin that gets you guys so fired up?
Well, when you buy a farm, you look at the crop every year and what prices are, and you decide whether it was a satisfactory investment. I mean, you look to the asset itself and what it produces for you. When we buy a business, we look at what the business earns and decide how we feel about it in terms of what we paid. But we are buying something that at the end of the period, we not only have what we bought in the first place, but we have something that the asset produced. And when you buy non-productive assets, all you're counting on is whether the next person is going to pay you more because they're even more excited about another next person coming along. But the asset itself is creating nothing. One of the interesting things, for example, is gold. If you go back to the time of Christ and you look at how many hours of labor you had to give up in order to buy an ounce of gold, and you take it forward to now, you'll find the compound rate, maybe a tenth or two-tenths of 1%. You know, and then you have to insure it during that time and make sure you know somebody doesn't steal it from you and everything. But it doesn't produce anything. And productive assets, you can pay too much for a productive asset. But I bought a farm in the 1980s, and every year, look at how much it produced, the way of soybeans and corn. And at the end of that period, I've still got the farm, and I've gotten some significant income off of it, apartment house, operating business. But if you and I buy various cryptocurrencies, they're not going to multiply. They're not going to be a bunch of rabbits sitting there in front of us. They're just going to sit there. And I got to hope next time you get more excited after I bought it from you, and then maybe I'll get more excited and buy it from you. And actually, we could sit in a house by ourselves, and we could keep running up the price between the two of us. But at the end of the time, there's one Bitcoin sitting there, and now we got to find somebody else. And they come to an end. I mean,
that's a greater fool theory. That's what you're saying.
It's buying something because you expect the pool of people who want to buy it because they want to sell it to somebody else will grow. And you know, it's wonderful because it does create a rising price, does create more buyers, and people think I've got to get in on this. And it's better if they don't understand it. That's the other thing about non-productive. If you don't understand it, you get much more excited than if you understand it. I mean, if you buy a bond that says it's going to pay you 4% a year, you're not going to get any pleasant surprises. She's going to pay you 4% a year. But if you can have anything you want to imagine, if you just look at something and say, that's magic. You can do it with shark's teeth or seashells or anything. And, you know, they did it with tulips in the 17th century in Amsterdam. And they'll do it again. I mean, people, they like to speculate. They like to gamble. And if you can get something, particularly if you have something half plausible going on. Mm-hmm. If you had bought gold in 1942 and you said, we might lose the war and we might have to run off to some other country and, you know, so let's put our assets in gold, you would have less than a penny for every dollar you got from owning stocks. Less than a penny. Now, if somebody calls that a store of value, I mean, I think they're delusional. Okay.